Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going. We don't dilute your video watching experience in this channel with sponsored products. If you like what we're doing, kindly support us at Patreon. www.patreon.com/defenseupdates.
Number 5.
Concern that the missile defense system designed to protect U.S. cities is insufficient by itself to deter a North Korean attack, the Trump administration is expanding its strategy to also try to stop Pyongyang's missiles before they get far from Korean airspace. The first involves stepped-up cyberattacks and other sabotage that would interfere with missile launches before they occur, what the Pentagon calls left of launch. The second is a new approach to blowing up the missiles in the boost phase when they're slow-moving, highly visible targets. In interviews, defense officials, along with top scientists and senior members of Congress, describe the accelerated effort as a response to the unexpected progress that North Korea has made in developing intercontinental ballistic missiles capable of delivering a nuclear weapon to the continental United States. "It's an all-out effort," said Senator Jack Reed of Rhode Island, the top Democrat on the Senate Armed Services Committee, who returned from a lengthy visit to South Korea last month, convinced that the United States needs to do far more to counter North Korea. "There's a fast emerging threat, a diminishing window, and a recognition that we can't be reliant on one solution." White House has requested $4 billion from the U.S. Congress for these new approaches to deal with North Korea. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the two new approaches U.S. plans to deal with North Korean missiles.
Number 4.
For years, the U.S. has invested in multi-layered missile defense systems. Ground-based mid-course defense is designed to protect U.S. mainland. Missile defense batteries of the system in Alaska and California could target any long-range warheads fired toward the U.S. mainland, trying to shoot them down as they re-enter the atmosphere. Patriot PAC-3 missile defense and Terminal High Altitude Area Defense, THAAD, stationed in South Korea and Japan to protect U.S. allies as well as intercept missiles that may target Guam. The third is the Aegis ballistic missile defense-enabled destroyers that are deployed in Korean waters to protect against medium-range missiles. All these systems have their hit and misses in tests and are not 100% proven solutions. Let us now look into the two new approaches one by one.
Number 3.
Using cyber weapons to disrupt launches is a radical innovation in missile defense in the past 3 decades. But in the case of North Korea, it's also the most difficult. It requires getting into the missile manufacturing, launch code, and guidance systems of a country that makes very limited use of the internet and has few connections to the outside world, most of them through China and, to a lesser degree, Russia. In the operation that began in 2014, a range of cyber and electronic interference operations were used against North's Musudan intermediate range missiles in an effort to slow its testing, but that secret effort had mixed results. The failure rate for the Musudan missiles soared to 88%, but it was never clear how much of that was due to the cyber attacks and how much to sabotage of the North supply chain and its own manufacturing errors. Then Kim Jong-un, the country's president, ordered a change in design, and the test launches have been far more successful.
Number 2.
The second idea is having stealth fighters such as the F-22 or the F-35 scramble from nearby bases in South Korea and Japan at the first sign of North Korean launch preparations. The jets would carry conventional air-to-air missiles and fire them at the North Korean long-range missiles after their launch, but they would have to fly relatively close to North Korea to do that, increasing the chances of being shot down. A drawback of boost phase defense is the short window to use it. Long-range missiles fire their engines for just 5 minutes or so. A boost phase idea getting much notice would be to have drones patrol high over the Sea of Japan awaiting a North Korean launch. Remote operators would fire heat-sensing rockets that lock onto the rising missiles. Leonard Kaveny, a main planner of the rocket-firing drones and a former Navy officer who directed science and technology at the Pentagon's anti-missile program from 1985 to 1997, said an accelerated program could produce the weapons in a year or less. Kaveny's team is considering arming the Avenger, a drone made by General Atomics, with a long-range missile. The Pentagon's Missile Defense Agency is also developing a drone that would fire potent laser beams at rising missiles, But recent plans would have it make its debut no sooner than 2025, too late to play a role in the current crisis or the Trump presidency. Even so, the effort has influential backers and could be seen as a long-term alternative. In the recent talk, Hyten of Strategic Command called lasers much better than interceptor rockets because they avoided questions over firing weapons into sovereign territories, especially to knock out missile test flights.
Number 1.
Han Taesung, the North Korea's ambassador to the United Nations, ruled out negotiations with America as long as joint U.S.-South Korea military exercises continued. He said the country was ready for new sanctions and dismissed the possibility of North Korea being added to a list of countries that sponsor terrorism. The ambassador was speaking at the North Korean mission in Geneva, as South Korea and the U.S. agreed in Seoul to keep cooperating towards a peaceful end to the crisis. A U.S. envoy said it was difficult to assess the intention of Pyongyang as there had been, quote, no signal, unquote. Experts argued that fleets of weapons with these new approaches patrolling near the north with looming threats of cyberattack, threatening to undo its strategic forces, could be extremely intimidating and create new diplomatic leverage. They may eventually bring North Korea back to the negotiating table.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.